The fifth cranial nerve, or the trigeminal nerve, is a mixed cranial nerve, and it contains both motor and sensory modalities. It's motor to the muscles of mastication, and it's sensory for your entire face, your forehead, part of your external ear, your oral cavity, the anterior part of your tongue, and your teeth. The trigeminal nerve is called the trigeminal nerve, tri meaning three, because it has three major branches. It has an ophthalmic, a maxillary, and a mandibular branch. The ophthalmic branch is sensory, all of it's sensory, and it exits the skull via the superior orbital fissure, which is this area here. The maxillary branch of the trigeminal nerve exits via the foramen rotundum, which is very difficult to see on this image, so I'm not even going to bother to try to point it out. The mandibular division exits the skull through the foramen ovale here. And it is both motor and sensory. Because of all of this sensory information that's being relayed by the ophthalmic, the maxillary, and the mandibular divisions of the trigeminal, we have a very large trigeminal ganglia that sits just about here in the skull. And again, that's the place for those primary sensory neurons. So the equivalent of the DRG for the face and for the oral cavity is the trigeminal ganglion that lives right there. The different branches of the trigeminal nerve are going to innervate different areas of the face. So our ophthalmic division is here. So this is V1. You'll see this nomenclature. Sometimes you'll see V1, V2, V3. Sometimes you'll see ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular. But for the sensory parts of these nerves on the face, we have V1 above the eyelid and the front part of the head. We have V2, which is going to innervate this aspect, the upper lip and the lower eyelid. And we have V3, the sensory component of the mandibular division that innervates the skin over the mandible and a little bit of this area of the side of the head. Oh, and what I forgot to mention earlier is that the mandibular division also innervates the anterior or presulcal part of the tongue. So remember that taste is carried by seven, but general sensation, whether you're pudding is smooth or lumpy, is going to be carried by the fifth cranial nerve for the anterior two-thirds. The muscles of mastication were covered by Dr. Alsup in the musculoskeletal MOOC, but I want to point them out to you. I have a few images here. So here is your masseter, and it's the very large muscle that you can feel when you clench your jaws. So if you clench your jaws really tight, you can feel your masseter muscle right off to the side here. Another important muscle of mastication is your temporalis muscle, which you can see here. And so if you put your fingers on the side of your head and bite down really hard, again, you can feel that muscle clenching. The others are deep to the mandible, and you can see them here. You can see the medial and lateral pterygoid muscles. And so those are the muscles that are innervated by the mandibular branch of five and are the muscles of mastication. So trigeminal nerve, cranial nerve five, three major branches, V1, V2, V3, also known as ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular. And you can remember them because it reflects their general distribution, sensory distribution on the surface of the face. In the next segment, we'll talk about the facial nerve.